How Liev Schreiber gets that perfect scruff is always the mystery of all time, isn't it? Mihok is here to talk about Ray Donovan and his music and a bunch of other things. The billboards are up. Have you seen them?
Yeah, I have.
How good's the season?
It's really good. It's really ambitious this year, and a lot of big twists are happening, bigger than ever before.
Well, here's the thing. I've enjoyed the show from the very beginning, and there are elements of the show that are startling. So when do you guys do a table read or how does it?
We do table reads.
Right.
Usually we get the first couple scripts and we're like, wow. And then, you know, it takes a little bit longer to try to catch up during the year. So we get surprised with scripts later on that shock us while we're reading them.
So did you find that to be the case this year?
A little bit. I mean, we kind of knew the arc. We knew the general arc of things. But once you get to about episode 8 or something, you're on the edge of your seat.
All right, people love, but they're all these good women throw themselves at Bunchy. Yeah. Why can't he sort it out?
He's trying to sort it out. He's trying to make right with his wife this year, and he goes on a little financial endeavor, and it doesn't work out, of course. But he also takes a little dip into Lucha Libre wrestling.
Okay, did you do any Lucha Libre training or?
No. Okay. I mean, I trained a lot, but and I watched the guys, but there was a few rehearsals.
Right. I am the coward of all time. Were you afraid you're gonna wreck your L5?
Oh yeah, I was freaking out all the time. I had people jumping on me, slamming me into the mat.
And you were like, not so tough.
Yeah, but it's all right. We little guys too. <All right. laughs> We'll see.
Here's Dash explaining to Ray that he wants to be a wrestler. Look.
What's going on, Bunch?
Daryl's been counting me.
What?
And Lena bossing me around with paper coffee.
Jeez.
I moved my family back from Pismo Beach for you, Ray. I'm here to help you. Okay,
well, I know you did, Bunch.
Well, I'm gonna be a luchador.
Who? What?
El Tribo.
What does that mean?
The Shamrock. 3 weeks, 10 cities, lucha on tour.
Dash, I want to know, what was your outfit? What did you have to
wear? Oh, yeah. You can see it online. It's online already. It's like a yellow and green, the Shamrock outfit.
Okay.
Nice.
Showing a lot of skin to work out a little bit more this year. But it was a hoot. It was a real hoot. The El Trebol. Take it to the bank.
There is, you guys act as family, but I think over this time, you guys probably very likely become family.
We are as tight as can be. And it always is. We just finished shooting, so it's always a heartbreak when I'm like, "Oh, well, we'll see each other." And we usually don't during the off season, but we try to.
But let me ask you. I tell you, it's just simply so much better than most shows. Do you spend more days doing it, or is it? What do you think are the elements that make it better?
Oh well, the writing is tremendous, and you know, David Hollander writes amazing scripts, and our staff, and the actors always elevate it. I mean, the crew we have is just everybody's so good, so everybody lifts each other up, and we don't go home until we love it.
Okay, and so could that mean 2, 3, 4 in the morning if need be?
Oh yeah, oh yeah.
Last time you were here, we were talking about your musical.
Yes.
What's going on with that?
Album's coming out in September. I actually just did a song with the girl who plays my niece on the show, Karis Dorsey, which is a really beautiful one. She's a great singer. And Diz and the Fam, Love and Loss, this fall.
What kind of music?
It's hip-hop, but with a twist.
All right. Hip-hop with a twist.
Yeah.
Well, wrestling twist.
We should tell you this. Season 5 premieres this Sunday at 9. Dash's song available now. Plus, there's a movie, So Be It. We'll get to that.
Yeah.
Come back in October and we'll talk about that.
You betcha.
Very good. Nice to see you, Dash.
Good to see
Thanks
you.
Thanks so much.
Thank you, sir.